Beverly Ho, Neighborinos, and welcome once again to another episode of Suck at Martha with me, Karen. Well, I'm going to get right to the point. The holiday season is here, whether you like it or not, and there are so many holidays being celebrated, not just traditional Christmas, but of course Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, and literally a myriad of different celebrations in between. But today we're going to focus in on Christmas, and one of the major symbols for Christmas is, of course, a Christmas tree. La voila. So what does this all mean? Well, I'm going to show you a craft that you can do very simply and very economically. The children are going to like it. Hopefully it'll keep them out of your hair for at least 15, 20 minutes. And it's something kind of cool that you can hang on your Christmas tree. Or of course there's other alternate things, which I will discuss at the end of the video. So this old lady took herself down to the dollar store, y'all. And cause you know, I loves to save my coins. And I picked up a few inexpensive items and we're going to recreate this lovely little Christmas tree ornament in less than 15 to 20 minutes and barely any swearing. Fingers crossed. So what do we need? What do we need to do? Let's get to it. So for starters, what do we need? Well, you need to pick up some cheap ass Christmas garland. This, of course, from the dollar store. This is so flim flammery that you don't need wire cutters. Simple scissors will do. And I doubt you're gonna use the entire length of it. So, you know, here's a helpful hint from Heloise. A sexy Christmas boa for you and your significant other. Really rock out the holidays. Anyway, you're also going to need, of course, a pair of scissors so that you can cut said sexy Christmas boa. You are going to need some popsicle sticks. Now, these, of course, are the super uber cheap ones found in the art aisle at the dollar store. I personally prefer them to be a little bit larger. Children's channel. You can get like the doctor's tongue depressors, but in a pinch, this will do, okay? You are going to need some string, some lovely colored string, such as this, okay? And as long as you can knot it, don't use regular thread, that's too thin. Get something with a little more substance. You are also going to need an assortment of buttons, la 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 la, which you can actually get at the dollar store. They have it in the sewing aisle. Can we just take a brief moment and discuss the travesty that is my hair right now? God, I'm so sorry. I just don't come to these things prepared, do I? Anyways, you can get little baggies, oh, buttons, in case you don't have a myriad of buttons at home like anyone else Susie Homemaker would have. You are also going to need Satan's tool, the glue gun. If there's anything that's going to make you discover religion, it's going to be this thing when you start yelling, oh God, because you're going to burn yourself, okay? So don't let the kiddies use this. If you have to do it, let them point out where they want things to be glued and you help them out. That's the whole point of being a parent, you know. And of course, you are going to need some scissors. So let's get to it. So you are going to take your popsicle stick and you're going to lay down a bead of glue. Don't go all the way to the bottom, okay? Just stay close to the top edge. And you're going to take two pieces of the garland, which you've already pre-cut, because you're responsible and organized like that. One is going to be a fairly long piece, and one's going to be a little bit shorter. Do you see how it's like coming together? Christmas tree! Okay, and you're going to glue the pieces on the tree thusly, okay? So that you see how it looks like a tree? Excellent. So then you are going to take a piece of string. I wish I was prepared. Okay, you're gonna take a piece of string and you're gonna knot it. Do you see how we, can we focus on that? There you go. You just knot it at the bottom, loop at the top. Perfect. And you are going to glue that to the back of your popsicle stick. Okay, so it ends up looking like this. Do you see? So that's going to be the place that you're going to hang. Then you are going to take your assortment of buttons. I would start out getting like maybe a white button or a gold button, something that's going to look like a star at the top. I'll show you my original one. You'll see how this one kind of looks like a little bit of a star. Try and find ones that look like, oh, there we go, focus. Try to look like ones like that. And then you're just gonna glue your buttons hither and yon all across the tree, as any child would. Now keep in mind, this is a child's craft, so get them to point out where these buttons need to go. And if you have like perfect ornament displacement syndrome, sucks to be you. Your kids are probably gonna load up one side with very ugly buttons and you're just gonna have to live with that shit. Okay, so anyways, you glue your buttons on and that's it. Done. Okay, so now here's where you can do some cool things with this. On the bottom half of the popsicle stick, you can actually take like a tiny marker or whatever, write the child's name. Maybe you could write a Christmas wish on there and hang that on your tree. Maybe you can use these as, you know, memorials for people or pets that you have lost in the past year and write their name on it and hang it on a Christmas tree. If you want to get really adventurous, why don't you make a shit ton of these and then write some encouraging words on it and hang them all over the town in which you live in, or city, just for other people to find. I'm just spitballing here, folks. A variation of this particular craft. You can glue all of this on, and then if you have spray adhesive, spray it down, and then just mash the crap out of this and a whole bunch of glitter, because isn't that what all the kids are all about right now, is glitter? And make the whole thing look like Santa himself has shat all over these branches. And that will keep the kids amused, and you'll be picking glitter out of the carpet and your family pets for weeks on end. Fun for the whole family. Anyway, that's it. I mean, I think that this whole craft cost me maybe $4, and now I'm sitting on more buttons than I care to discuss and far too much garland. And I'm gonna have to come up with some kind of cool crafts with the rest of the shit. So anyways, that's it. Guys, easy peasy, super cheapy, and keeps the kids amused. Ta-da! Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. As per usual, if you have not subscribed to my channel, hit that little button down below. Subscribe to my channel, see what other crap and fuckery I can get up to. Also hit that little bell notification, because apparently if you don't hit the bell, then you don't get alerted as to when I actually do post stuff. And since it's very erratic, I think you probably need to know when I'm posting stuff. You can also find me on Pinterest. Lady Safi is my moniker there, LadySafi. You can also comment or question me, or maybe you have some concerns about the language I use in these apparently child-friendly videos. And you can contact me at suckitmartha1@gmail.com. Guys, that's it. Hopefully next time we talk, I'll have a different holiday craft for you. I'm trying to find some Hanukkah ideas, to be honest. So if you have any Hanukkah ideas that you would like to see me tackle, head on over to Pinterest, find something interesting, and send it my way via my email, suckitmartha1@gmail.com, or comment below, whatever you choose. I hope that this holiday season is finding you less stressed out. I think that the world is crazy enough as it is. It doesn't need your sorry ass in there. And I guess I will see you later.